Tengku Imran berkata mentaliti untuk mengejar pingat emas di temasya dui tahunan itu tidak lagi realistik ketika atlet elit perlu mempunyai aspirasi lebih besar iaitu mengungguli peringkat Sukan Asia, Commonwealth dan Olimpik selain kejohanan dunia dalam acara masing-masing.
That's because our politicians and all our leaders are always talking about they want to be top of the pile in SEA Games, you know, and all those type of things. I think they should, you know, be very clear that okay, we want to do as well as possible in the SEA Games, but those gold medals, you know, is not the be all and the end all. They, you know, it's what happens afterwards. Last year, I mean, SEA Games was only in December. You already have Olympics in July. That's only 7 months later. So many of those athletes' focus should have been qualifying for Olympic Games and you know, seeing how well, you know, they can do in Olympics rather than winning you know, a gold medal in the SEA Games.
Tengku Imran yang juga pengerusi Sport Excel ditemui pada majlis penyerahan dana berjumlah RM54,000 kepada 41 atlet muda cemerlang dari 9 jenis sukan sepanjang 2019. Menurut beliau, Sukan SEA hanyalah langkah pertama pendedahan di peringkat antarabangsa dan idea bagi menghantar atlet muda adalah tepat bagi mewujudkan ekosistem prestasi yang berkesinambungan.
You know, it's the youngsters, the young ones are the one that's probably going to benefit more from participating in SEA Games than the older athletes because they learn more.
Malaysia tidak perlu bimbang untuk kehilangan banyak emas dengan keputusan itu kerana ia adalah sesuatu yang positif untuk masa depan. Ia bagi memastikan kem negara tidak lagi ketandusan atlet berbakat seperti dilakukan Vietnam dan Thailand sejak beberapa edisi lalu.
Okay, thank you, Tengku.